Hello my dear students, today in this class we shall see some more formulae which are very useful while solving the examples. Sometimes questions they may ask the questions depending on this formulae. Okay, so let us see. Students, you know that suppose let and take in sin inverse x equal to a and sin inverse y equals to capital B, suppose, where capital A and capital B belongs to the minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 in the closed interval, because we know that the principal value branch of the sin inverse function is closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, now here as sin inverse x equal to a, therefore, it uses x equal to sin A. Sin A here, y will be equal to sin B. Squaring here, x square, that is sin square A. Here, y square equal to sin square B. Now, subtract both the sides from 1. So, it gives us 1 minus x square equal to 1 minus sin square A. Here also 1 minus y square equal to 1 minus sin square b. Now 1 minus x square equals to 1 minus sin square a is cos square a. Cos square a. And 1 minus y square, 1 minus sin square b means cos square b. Therefore, under root 1 minus x square will be cos a, and under root 1 minus y square will be cos b. Okay. So, you remember this. These are useful in our formula. Okay. Now, we know that sin a plus b. You have learned this formula in class 11. Sin a plus b. Sin into cos b. Sin A into cos B plus cos A into sin B. Okay. Therefore, sin A plus B equals to sin A. What is sin A? Sin A is x. So, I am substituting here instead of sin as x. Then cos B. What is cos B? Under root 1 minus y square. 1 minus y square. Then cos into sin B. Sin B, sin B is y. What is cos A? Cos is under root 1 minus x square into 1 minus x square. Therefore, A plus B will be equals to sin inverse x into under root 1 minus y square plus y into under root 1 minus x square, where a plus b belongs to the closed interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Now what is a? A is, what is a? A is sin inverse x. Therefore, sin inverse x plus sin inverse y equals to sin inverse in bracket x under root 1 minus x square plus y under root 1 minus y square plus y under root 1 minus x square. So, this is the formula which we have derived here. Sin inverse x plus sin inverse y equal to sin inverse x into under root 1 minus y square plus y into under root 1 minus x square. Similarly, we can have another formula. That is second one, cos inverse x plus cos inverse y equal to cos inverse in bracket x one x into y and minus under root 1 minus x square into 1 minus y square. Now you derive yourself. You try for this one and you derive it. Okay. Now, let us take an example depending on this formula. Example, if cos inverse x upon a, cos inverse x upon a plus cos inverse y upon b equals to alpha, suppose this is given. Cos inverse x upon a plus cos inverse y upon b equals to alpha, suppose, okay, then you have to prove that x square upon a square, x square upon a square, the minus twice xy upon a into b into cos alpha plus y square upon b square equals to sine square alpha. This is the reason which you want to prove here. Now what is given here? Given is cos inverse x upon a plus cos inverse y upon b equals to alpha. So using this, you have to prove this. Okay. So prove as cos inverse x upon a plus cos inverse y upon b equals to alpha. So I am using here formula cos inverse x plus cos inverse y. So that will be cos inverse x into y. So x upon a into y upon b, x into y. Okay, x into y. That is this first into the second minus under root 1 minus x squared. So 1 minus domain of the first inverse function. So 1 minus x upon a whole square into 1 minus second y upon b whole square. Okay, in this way, that is equals to alpha, which is equals to alpha. Okay, now simply by, so I can write this as x into y, xy upon ab minus under root 1 minus x square upon a square under root 1 minus y square upon b square equals to this thing. Cos equals to cos alpha. This will be cos alpha. Therefore, xy upon ab, take this cos alpha to left hand side, that is cos alpha equal, take this term to right hand side, v equals to under root 1 minus x square upon a square into 1 minus y square upon b square. Now squaring both the sides, squaring the row, ignore the multiplication here, squaring both the time, first term square, x square, y square upon a square, b square, first term square, minus 2 times first term into second term, xy upon ab into cos alpha, right, plus second term square, cos square alpha equals to, this square root will be removed, so 1 minus x square upon a square into 1 minus y square upon b square. Okay. Therefore, x square y square upon a square b square minus twice xy upon ab cos alpha plus cos square alpha equals to x1, this 1 into this 1, then 1 into minus y square upon b square, that is y square upon b square then this minus x square upon a square into 1, that will be minus x square upon a square, then minus x square upon a square into minus x square upon y square upon b square. So it will be plus x square y square upon a square b square. Now we are having same terms to the left hand side also, so we cancel it. Okay, here it is equal to, you cancel it. Therefore, we get, take this minus x square upon a square to left hand side, so x square upon a square, then this minus 2xy, minus 2xy upon ab into cos alpha, this term, okay, then take this minus y square upon b square to left hand side, that is plus y square upon b square, then we are remaining here 1 minus, transfer this cos square alpha to that side, cos square alpha, now this is sin square alpha, therefore x square upon a square minus twice xy ab cos alpha plus y square upon b square equals to sin square alpha. So in this way we can do the result. Okay. Well, take another question. Prove that second one. Prove that 9 pi by 4 into sine inverse 1/3 into sine inverse 1/3. Okay, this is equals to, you have to prove that this is equals to 9/4 sine inverse 2√2/3. Okay, now let us do this. What is left hand side here? Left hand side is 9 pi by 8 minus 9/4 sine inverse 1/3. We start from this left hand side. So left hand side equal to 9 pi by 8 minus 9/4 sine inverse 1/3. Okay. So taking 9/4 as common. So we remain here. Pi by 2, so 9 will, it is taken out, so pi, this will be 2, pi by 2 minus in the sine inverse 1/2, that is equals to 9/4, we know that sine inverse x plus cos inverse x equals to pi by 2. So pi by 2 minus sin inverse x will be cos inverse x. So here pi by 2 minus sin inverse 1/3 will be cos inverse 1/3, cos inverse 1/3. But we want the answer in sin inverse, 9/4 sin inverse. So let us convert this cos inverse 1/3 in sin inverse. So here, suppose you have a right angle triangle, like this is theta. I am taking cos theta equal to 1/3. Cos theta, let me say ABC. So cos theta, this will be 1, this will be 3. 1/3, adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So definitely this side will be root 8 according to Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, what will this implies? Theta equal to cos inverse 1/3. Theta equals to cos inverse 1/3. So this is your theta, cos inverse 1/3. Now let us find out sin theta. Sin theta will be 1 of adjacent, opposite side root 8 upon 3. Okay. Therefore theta equal to sin inverse root 8/3. So this is also theta. sin theta, theta is equal to cos inverse 1 by 3, theta is equal to sin inverse of 8 by 3. Theta, theta, left hand sides are same, right hand side must be equal. So that is cos inverse 1 by 3 must be equal to sin inverse root 8 by 3. So that is 9 by 4 sin inverse root 8 by 3. Now root 8 means 9 by 4 sin inverse root 8 means 2 root 2 by 3, which is equal to right hand side. Okay. So in this way we can prove this. Then one more last question. Evaluate sine inverse 0.4. Evaluate this. We know that three sine inverse x equal to sine inverse 3x minus 4x cube. 3x minus 4x cube. So I'll apply the same formula. This will be sine inverse x. This question we have already done in the first exercise. 3 sine inverse x. So 3 sine inverse x is sine inverse 3x. I'm writing this. Sin inverse 3x, x is 0.4, 3x minus 4x cube, x is 0.4, so 0.4 whole cube. Okay, so 3 sin inverse 0.4, V sin inverse 0.4 can be written as sin inverse 3x, 3 into this x 0.4 minus 4x cube. So that is equal to sine of sine inverse. This will be 1.2 minus 4 into 0.4 whole cube, 0.064. Okay. Then, which is equal to sine of sine inverse 1.2 minus 4 into 0.256, that is sine inverse 0.944. So sine of sine inverse, so that is equals to 0.944. This is the answer. Okay, so other examples, words you try, there are different examples, so you thoroughly practice all the examples. All the best. Thank you.